Good morning, everyone. First, I want to take a moment to congratulate President Donald Trump on his historic win in Iowa, earning more votes than all the other candidates combined. The people of Iowa spoke loudly and clearly, echoing the sentiment felt throughout the rest of the country. America is rallying in support of President Trump to save America and fire Joe Biden. Yesterday, I had the honor of meeting with Israeli Ambassador Herzog. This past Sunday marked 100 days since the Hamas terrorist attacks against Israel, the bloodiest day for the Jewish people since the Holocaust. House Republicans will continue to stand unequivocally with Israel. House Republicans passed a robust aid package under Speaker Mike Johnson's leadership, and yet Joe Biden and Chuck Schumer continue to fail to deliver support to our most precious ally. This week, House Republicans will welcome hundreds of thousands of our constituents proudly participating in the March for Life. The most important and meaningful title I have ever had in my life is Mom. We will continue to fight every day to ensure every baby has the sacred opportunity of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Unfortunately, life is under constant attack by radical far-left Democrats. There have now been over 88 recorded acts of violence and intimidation against pregnancy centers, churches, and pro-life organizations by far-left activists. These facilities were set ablaze, defaced, and vandalized. And what have we heard from Joe Biden and Democrats in Washington? Silence. Under the leadership of House Republicans, we passed the Born Alive Abortion Survivors Protection Act and a resolution condemning attacks on these pro-life facilities, groups, and churches following the Dobbs decision. In continuation of our commitment to defending life, this week House Republicans will bring to the floor the Pregnant Students' Rights Act and the Supporting Pregnant and Parenting Women and Families Act to support critical pregnancy resource centers and provide necessary information to pregnant students combating manipulation by the far left's radical pro-abortion agenda. With that, I am honored to introduce one of my colleagues and friends and another mom in Congress, Ashley Hinson from the great state of Iowa, to discuss her bill on the floor this week. Ashley.